Hi everyone, my name is Loic Michel. I work at Ifremer in Brest, France, and today I'd like to talk to you about DeepIso, which is a global open database of stabilized isotope ratios and elemental contents for deep sea ecosystems. The use of stable isotopes as ecological tracers in deep sea ecosystems dates back to several decades, and they have been instrumental to many key findings, as evidenced by this selection of big old papers. However, due to constraining sampling logistics, the temporal, spatial, or taxonomic scope of deep sea studies is commonly limited, and as a result, much is left to discover about factors globally influencing food web structure and ecological interactions in deep sea ecosystems. To address this issue, we wanted to produce a global, easily discoverable, available, and reusable compilation of stable isotope ratios and elemental contents in organisms from deep sea ecosystems. And what we wanted to achieve through that was to provide the deep sea community with an open data analysis tool that can be used in the context of future ecological research, and therefore to help deep sea researchers to use stable isotope markers at their full efficiency. So together with these fine folks, we set out to contact even more people, and we were lucky enough to receive positive answers from those handsome fellas that agreed to share their data with us. And that resulted in the first version of DeepIso that was released in October last year. You can download the database using the link that you see now on the screen if you want to have a look. It's under CC by license, and what you will find inside is about 19,000 measurements of seven parameters, mostly carbon and nitrogen isotopes, but also a bit of sulfur. Those measurements pertain to almost 4,500 distinct samples, mostly taken in hydrothermal vents, benthic ecosystems, or cold seeps. And those samples are linked with almost 5,500 different taxa, the bulk of which are crustaceans, mollusks, and policates. From a spatial point of view, we have almost global latitude and longitude cover, and the depth range is going up to over 5,000 meters. And from a temporal point of view, we have mostly samples taken in recent years, but we also have quite a few old data points that date back to the late 80s. What we would like to do now is to integrate DeepIso with larger scale initiatives such as the IsoBank, but in the meantime, we would also like to keep building up the database and maximize its scope by integrating more data. And for that, of course, we need you, because we are looking for people willing to share data, either underlying published articles, grey literature, or even unpublished data. We can help with data formatting and data publication if you required help on those aspects. So if you feel like contributing, if you have any questions about the initiative, if you have feedback about the database, please feel free to get in touch. I thank you for your attention, and I say goodbye.